Let's go. Welcome home to 42 Geek Street, your guide to the world of the geek, that little bit of geek in all of us. Hi, I'm Ren, and with me today is Mike.
Hi.
Hello, Mike.
Hello.
Thank you for joining me and helping me on today's show.
Not a problem. Always fun.
Always. On today's show, we're going to go to and see Star Walking.
Ooh.
Yes. And you don't know what that is, do you?
No.
And you're going to find out. We're also going to check out a few things at Oz Comic Con. And I believe you went somewhere. Where did you go to, Mike?
I went to the Big Arse launch earlier this year.
Yes, you did. But right now, though, you need to interview someone in the crew. And who you be interviewing?
Well, let's find out. Why don't you click your fingers and we'll see who turns up in this very scene.
Let's do that right now. I guess it's me.
Yeah, I guess it's you.
Whoa, dude.
All right, so let's get things rolling. What got you involved with the geek scene?
Well, I always been into geeky kind of stuff. I love all the movies. I also love gaming. I did a lot of Dungeons & Dragons ever since high school.
Okay, yeah.
Well, actually, then it was Dragon Warriors.
So you're the traditional style of board gaming before the
dice.
Online.
Yeah, so the dice rolling. I love my dice. I still sometimes decide things on dice just for fun. Also, I got lost in the world of Warcraft for a while.
It's a dangerous world of
it's
Warcraft.
It's a dangerous world. You get in there and it's, I can't get out. But I finally got out and discovered board games. And I have a mountain of board games. Not as big as I'd like it, you know. It's always better to have more games and having lots of fun with that. I was always surprised at how much fun you can have with board games.
Yep.
And then I got into podcasting. You had a podcast and Ron had a podcast, so I thought, why not? I want to have a podcast. So I got Ron jumped on board, and I pull you in every now and then. And then after a while, Ron's like, hey, let's have a TV show. So
see, it's good TV fun, show. Isn't it? See, that's what it's all about.
And like Ron mentioned previously, it's meeting all these people has been really awesome.
Mm.
So it's been a very exciting thing. And I've learned so much. There's so many things I can go to now and do once I finished all the editing and stuff.
Why? Because you edit and stuff.
Yes.
Wow.
It's lots of fun.
Doesn't this just magically all come together?
Well, the clicking happens and the changeover and stuff. It's pretty cool. But yeah, so basically I'm a bit of a geek. I love games, movies, and just general geekism, but in a basic form.
In a basic form. Mm. Okay. Well, thank you for sharing your story with us, Ren.
No problems. Now we should go back to the host, you think?
Yeah, we should go back to the host. I'm curious to see how this is all going to work. It's
some way, actually. Yeah. Who knows what I'm going to end up with?
Well, that's right. Hopefully, we'll see Ren after these few short seconds.
Could be Ron, actually.
It could be Ron.
Could be anyone.
Could be anyone.
All right, here we go. Huh?
Try that again.
Oh!
All right, okay, so you back?
Yeah, hey, look, magic's a volatile thing. It doesn't always work out the way you want it.
It's the magic.
Just like the dice rolls.
Yes, I think we rolled a 10 rather than a 6.
Actually, we rolled a 1.
That was a 1.
Out there.
Oh.
An instant miss. I got Ron instead.
I've only played occasionally, so I've got no idea.
You will. But now, I think it's time for us to visit Oz Comic Con, where Lauren actually did a bit of cosplay interviewing, where she met a very interesting person.
Ooh. Let's check in on that.
Yeah.
Hey guys, I'm here with international cosplay superstar, Kelly Xena Mitchell. How are you doing, Kelly?
I'm doing very well, thank you. How are you?
Very well. You're not dressed in your normal Xena attire today.
I know, I've ditched the leathers today and put on something a bit more casual. Yep, so I've gone with the Wonder Woman bombshell attire. I saw the statues come out recently for the series and I fell in love with it straight away and was just like, yep, I have to make this costume. So with 2 weeks to go to the con, I just got out the materials and then here it is.
You have a bit of a theme with your strong women. You like to have a nice sort of confident cosplay look.
something that I've always grown up with. I like the idea of strong women. I like the idea of women who can just get theirs and, you know, do things for themselves, just independent, know what they want, get what they want, and just, yeah, be proud and happy doing it.
So, Kelly, why cosplay?
It's an outlet, I think. You know, like, in today's society, we're just... You know, we have that set path that we know we have to go on, and cosplay is just kind of a step out of that reality where we can just sort of just take the step aside and just be someone who we want to be in any kind of universe that we want to be, and yeah, just dress fabulously for a day in any attire that we like, and it's good fun.
What is your favorite thing about fandom?
I like the coming together of fandom, especially that it can bring different people from different cultures, societies, even languages together. With the Xena community in particular, we have people from all over the world, France, Brazil, US, Australia, New Zealand, all over the world. We all come together and just talk about the love for one show of Xena. And it's just great that there's just that one thing that can bring just a multitude of people together. And it's great.
Thank you so much for your time today, Kelly. You look amazing.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Hope you have a great day and enjoy Oz Comic Con.
Coming up right after the break, Starwalking. Welcome back to 42 Geek Straight. And now we're going to see Starwalking with Chris Brennan with Ron.
Starwalking!
Hi guys, I'm with Chris, director of Starwalking. Chris, do you want to tell us what Starwalking is and what this is all about?
Starwalking is the Star Wars Appreciation Society of Australia. Yeah. In essence, we're the Star Wars fan club for Australia, and we are the longest running Star Wars fan club in the world.
In the world?
In the world. Been around for over 25 years now. Technically, okay. We've been around longer than the official club, but they don't like us saying that.
No, so we won't say that at
no,
all.
No, we won't say that, no.
And what's the event that we're here at today?
Today we're at Skyforce. Now, Skyforce is the social club of Starwalking. So we have an arm of the club that looks after the social aspects. So the movie screenings, the bowling nights and all that sort of thing.
Yeah.
And we have our regular Skyforce meetings, which we hold 5 times a year in Melbourne.
Yeah.
Where all the fans get together, come around, have a bit of fun, get the latest news from Episode 7 and Rebels, see some of the weird and wonderful things that you can find on the internet. And we also have dealers and that here selling off collectibles. And we have a video program, and we also have games underway, and all sorts of really great fun things for fans of all ages to come along and enjoy.
And if fans want to get involved, what is it that getting involved means?
Getting involved just simply means, well, number one, coming along to a Skyforce meeting. If you want to be an armchair fan, you can go to the website, which is starwalking.net. You can join the club there,
yeah,
and you'll get regular updates. Our monthly newsletter, it's about to go monthly, monthly publication will come out to you. And that'll keep you up to date on all the latest news. But basically, it's just being involved, just getting with fans and coming along to one of the events.
And what are the sort of things that happen at one of these events if I'm a new person walking through the door?
Well, you walk in the door and the first thing you do is you're greeted by our wonderful secretary who will be sitting at the door smiling at you and taking some money off you. So it does cost a little bit to get in the door, but we try and keep our costs as low as possible.
Yeah.
And children under 12 are free. We're the paying adult, so the whole family can come along and have a great time.
Yeah, just for a few dollars, yeah.
Yeah, and we've got a kitchen here, so you don't go hungry, which is an important thing if you're a fan. You've got to have food.
Yeah. Being a full day.
Yeah, then just basically come in and look around and meet some of the fans that are there and look for the people who are wearing these wonderful blue shirts, which is our club shirt. they're the official people who will show you around and tell you what to do and point you in the right direction. If you've got any questions, ask our guys and they're happy to tell you.
Okay, that sounds excellent. Well, thank you very much for being on the show and letting us come down and introduce the club. So guys, if you are interested in Star Wars, can highly recommend come and join these guys and talk all things Star Wars. So we'll see you later.
May the Force be with you.
Always.
Now that was a fun day at Starwalking. I actually got to go down there and do the filming and all that. And it was actually cool to see all the items they had around. And they even had auctions down there. Auctioning away, it's pretty cool.
Selling stuff.
And you know who else I saw down there? Dags from Con 70 was down there, which we're going to see later on in the season.
Yeah, he was cool.
Yeah. Now we're going to go back to Oz Comic Con.
Yes.
We had Tarquin interviewing. So basically, it's Gary Jones from Stargate and a fanboy. This is basically watching a fanboy interviewing his hero.
You fanboyed out.
And this is how it turned out.
Hey everybody, I'm a little bit bit of starstruck with Gary Jones, Walter from Stargate SG-1, and every other Stargate, come to think of it.
Yeah, yeah, I'm one of the few actors who has been on all three franchises. Yeah, so I'm basically I'm the answer in a drinking game or Trivial Pursuit.
Did you make? You made it in the movies, didn't you?
Yeah, I did the movies. I did all three franchises, and
yeah. So everyone else popped back.
One of the few guys.
Yeah. Now, here we are at Comic Con. What's it like being here with the fans? This is the front line.
This is the trenches. This is absolutely the trenches. Oh, it's great. It's great. I can tell already my voice is a little squeaky. I'm starting to lose my voice because I've been talking all weekend. I'm jet lagged, but I love Australia. I tell them I keep wanting to come back, and they brought me back. It's great. This is my second time in Melbourne, and I was in Brisbane and Adelaide in November, so great. It's awesome. Aussie fans are fantastic.
And the first time in Melbourne, was it though?
Second
time. So the three new movies coming up, as we know, like the first movie is going to be based around Stargate, the series, or at least there, and then he's going to go off and do something else.
Right.
Now, have you gone up and gone, I am available?
No.
No?
No, no.
No?
No, you just don't do that.
Oh, well.
No, you really don't do that. You either get the call or you don't.
Well, so, to me, your character started as, guy in background, I suppose. I'm not sure what you're that. And then you developed, when he signed my Stargate, which you just thank you for that.
Yes.
I
was Chevron guy.
Yeah. And you got the most amount of character development any character.
You think?
Oh, yeah. You start off as guy in background, and then Stargate Command is not Stargate Command unless you got Walter there.
It doesn't work. Well, they mixed and matched in season three. They had other technicians, but then they brought me back.
Yeah.
And they need somebody to open and close the gate, so they decided finally that was me.
Yeah.
And they changed my name over 10 years. Mm-hmm. Went from sergeant to master sergeant to chief master sergeant, mm-hmm. chief master sergeant Norman Davis to chief master sergeant Walter Harriman. And how do you make that leap? They can do that in 10 years if they're the producers.
Yeah, but I mean, one of the best bits I loved was when the Hammond is there, he goes like, yeah, I'm coming back for the chair. Oh, and I'm taking Walter too. And so,
oh, yeah, right. You know, right. I forgot about that line.
Yeah, you went from guy who opens gate to I'm the adjutant to the person running the facility.
Yeah. Well, a lot of military non-com personnel have come to these Stargate conventions, and they've actually told me, they say, your character, Walter, basically runs the gate.
Yeah.
The officers do nothing. The non-com people are the ones who do all the work.
The officers screw up a lot. It's just like, what did Carter do this time? What have we brought through the gate? What's exploded? What's infected us? What's gone wrong? And there's always Walter going, keeping calm.
Yeah.
Don't worry.
It's true.
If you had the chance to go into the movie, we don't ask. Okay, you don't make that call. Where did you? Well, even if the series had continued, where would you see Walter end up going?
Walter can't. I had basically reached the glass ceiling with Walter. He couldn't get, I was a non-commissioned officer, so I couldn't go any higher. That was as high as I could go, unless they sort of overrode that and gave me some sort of special, papal dispensation, and allowed me to go, be part of SG-1.
Thank you for talking to us. Thank you for putting up with my rabid fanboyism.
You're welcome.
We'll cut this down and make it, but all of this will be somewhere on the website, okay? Whatever this gets cut down to.
Just turn it off.
Yeah, turn it off.
We're done.
Well, that was pretty
cut.
Okay, that was really interesting. But yeah, it's just, I guess that what happens when a fanboy meets their hero. And Gary Jones was really awesome. He was great. Ron got to speak to him, and he was great to talk to and everything. And yeah, it was fun to see him talking to Tarquin in that one. But also at Oz Comic Con, you met a very interesting person, someone you know very well.
Yes, Mr. Dean Arcuri, who's part of the Watcher podcast. And he was part of the Queer Geeks panel that was on at Oz Comic Con. So we went down to check it out, and we also spoke to him afterwards to see what he had to say.
Hi, it's Mike here again for 42 Geek Street, and with me today we have Mr. Dean Arcuri, famous for...
Well, lots of things, aren't I? I'm Dean from Gyfy Podcast, also from Watcher Podcast with Mike. And at the Queer Geeks of Oz panel, I forgot what I was here for. The Queer Geeks of Oz panel at Oz Comic Con.
Okay, now, this is the second year it's been going, correct?
Well, this is, previously there was a Queer Geeks of Oz panel at Armageddon. Oz Comic Con are going to have one at each of their conventions all over Australia.
Now, you just finished the panel now, and really good panel. How'd you feel?
Oh, look, there was a really great turnout. I feel like I did a lot of talking about comics.
Not a bad thing.
It's funny, we were actually on a panel with a whole lot of gamers, so we were all sitting talking about gaming and queer representation and characters, and then when it came to comics, it was just me talking a lot and people nodding, but there was this great woman in the front who was arguing with me, which was fantastic.
It's not often you can get an argument in with Dean, so when you can take someone on, because I'm no challenge, it's good.
He is the biggest pushover ever. It was really great. We got to get up there and talk about queer representation in comics and games and popular culture. It's a funny thing, though. I feel like sometimes I'm a bit of a stickler. I want good characters, not necessarily gay characters. That's the way that I like it to be. And as long as they're told well and their experiences are told well, that's all that really matters.
Now, if people want to find out more info about Queer Geeks of Oz, where can they go?
You can head to Facebook and just look up Queer Geeks of Oz. There's a lot of people from the panel today who have said they're going to join and start interacting and talking and organise social groups, which is great and fantastic.
Awesome. Well, thank you for your time, Dean. I'll see you next week at the podcast.
See you, Mike.
And we'll see you next time.
So coming up after the break, we've got...
Big Ass Launch with Brendan.
True story.
It is. It really is. Welcome back to 42 Geek Street. Now, coming up, we have Brendan at the Big Arse launch, Brendan Halyday, who was just going to show us one of the books that he was launching on the day, and a little bit of history as to, you know, what got him into comic books, as well as the comic itself.
Cool, let's check that out then.
Hi, and welcome again to Geek Street. You're here with Mike, and today we're down at the Big Arse launch for number 4. Down at the Fitzroy Beer Garden, the address being, Brendan?
243 Gertrude Street, Fitzroy.
Excellent. All right, and Brendan is here with me today. Now, he is the head honcho here who has put this all together. So, Brendan, how long has Big Arse Launch been happening for at the moment?
Yeah, so there's been 4 launches so far. There's one annually, usually every year around the end of February or the start of March or early March. It's been about promoting local comics as well as notable comic works from creators from other states or even from New Zealand.
Okay. No, beautiful. That's awesome. So you've got a few artists on today, a few different books.
Yes, so there's 9 different books launching here today. Or in fact, there's 10 because one of the books is a flip book with issue 3 and 4 in the one flip book comic.
All right, so that's definitely one to check out, I think, definitely.
That's System Earth. It's a wonderful book.
So I suppose, what is the importance of local support when it comes to these kind of events?
I think there's a lot of benefits to these launches. Creators who are self-publishing the books actually plop down a lot of money to print these books, and the launches help you to recoup a lot of that money more quickly. To sort of alleviate the costs. It also allows us to interact with our fans, which is really important as well, because writing or drawing comics can be quite a solitary task. And we do it because we love comics or storytelling. And it's nice to be able to interact with the fans and, you know, do a sketch in a book or sign a book or, you know, whatever it might be, Mikey, and you know.
Yeah. Well, about yourself, you've got your next issues here as well?
Absolutely, yeah, I do.
So what have you got here today?
So my main book for today is Panic Issue 2. Panic is an ongoing series. It's quite a long story. And it's more or less me. It's all autobiographical, and it's me, I guess, showing my experiences with mental illness, mm-hmm. with anxiety disorder, and all the related things like that. Yeah. So,
which can actually be, as well as being something to read for the average Joe, it's also somewhere to help people in a similar situation kind of get an understanding of that too.
It's absolutely about that. When I first had a mental health issue, I was probably in my early to mid-20s, mm-hmm. and there just wasn't material available to explain to my friends and family what was actually happening to me. Mm. And some of them, I think, really failed and struggled to understand what I was going through. And it wasn't through their lack of trying, it was just that in a lot of ways there wasn't adequate documentation to explain what it's actually like. So I'm actually trying to make comics that are enjoyable and fun to read, but also that really communicate what it's like to be mentally ill and to, you know, to lose your job or have to stop working, and and to really go from being high functioning to very low functioning. And it's, you know, obviously it's quite a frustrating experience, as I'm sure you'd imagine.
Yep. What else did you have here today as well?
Well, I also have Oswald Monster Wrestler. Now, this beauty was drawn by Andy Isaac and co-written by myself and Andy. And let me just say, he's a talented artist for sure. He's one of the most talented artists in the Melbourne scene. And this beautiful thing folds out to this massive A2 sized poster.
That's impressive.
with a big money shot there in the middle. The big kablah!
No, that is great. We saw that down at the All-Star earlier today, and that's a really good one. So if you guys are looking for this after seeing this broadcast, check it out at one of the stores in Melbourne. They'll all have it in stock as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
And what's the last one you've got there?
The last book I have here, this is one that I published and edit.
Yep.
So I've been selectively publishing and editing just a couple of works by other people.
Yep.
And this is 51% issue 2, written and drawn by Chris Gooch. I think Chris is one of the most talented young writer-artists in the Melbourne comic scene. And this beautiful thing has nice little fancy French flaps as well. and it's for fans of, you know, Daniel Clowes and Adrian Tomina, Seth, Joe Matt, Chester Brown, Chris Ware, the sort of indie cartoonists. That's the kind of work that Chris produces. It's very well written, thought-provoking, edgy, creative. He's an extremely talented young man, and I think that he could be the next Simon Hanselman.
Okay.
In terms of Australian indie darlings, he's a gun.
All right, awesome. Well, thanks for coming down to talk to us, or thanks for talking to us while we've come down here. And enjoy the rest of the show, and I hope you guys do really well today.
Not a problem. Thanks for having me on, Mike.
Cool. Cheers.
Cheers.
That was actually pretty awesome of Brendan to share that with us.
Yeah, definitely. It's not an easy thing to do, and especially to put it into his work that way. It's a very brave thing, so, you know, and it's a great help to people who are suffering depression as well. So we racked up those different contacts.
Let's do it again, just here. Yep. Contact these. And the fact that he was able to do that and still put out a book as well, that's pretty awesome.
Exactly. Now we're going to have a few other guys coming up in the next week or so from Big Arse Launch as well, talking about their books, so you can find out more information there too.
Cool. Now that concludes our show for today. Now, if anybody wants to contact us at all in any way, shape, or form, Facebook is an awesome way to contact us.
FB.
Yeah. And share.
Please share.
Please share. Thanks again, Mike.
Not a problem.
And we'll catch everyone next week.
Later, puppies.
Later.